Orphan children roam the streets, begging for food as my sisters and I hurry towards the bus stop for school. They reach out towards me, and even though I want to help them, I swat their hands away and keep walking. In Lesotho, poverty is a large problem causing famine, unsafe living conditions, and diseases that cause early deaths that leave hundreds of orphan children on their own. My name is Ceci Lakota, and I live in Maseru, the capital of Lesotho. My dad has a job as a reporter at the capital, and my mom stays home, which is traditional in the Lesotho culture. I am the oldest of two. I have two twin sisters, Atile and Moza, who are 9. I am 13, and I go to the Wee School, which is free up until 8th grade, which is next year for me. Sometimes my mom tells me that girls are better students than boys in Lesotho. After all, she says, over 84% of girls in Lesotho are enrolled in school, surpassing boys. Every year in September, our family takes a trip to Celebathebe National Park, and we go on a hike. I look forward to this trip every year because I get to eat the Bazotho burger, which is a meat dish, and watch the men dance in a traditional dance called the Mohobelo, which involves kicking and jumping. Celebathebe is located in the Maloti Mountains, which is north of Maseru. The real reason that we go there is because of the ancient rock paintings and the Bazotho stone dwellings that were made there a long time ago. These dwellings could be from the later and earlier Stone Ages. Once on a class trip, we visited the government building, and our teacher gave us a lesson on how the government works. Lesotho is one of the last monarchies in Africa, except it's also democratic. Our king, Letsi III, does almost nothing and is forbid from engaging in political activities. The main person who rules the country is our prime minister. A broken trust can never be regained, Thomas the Bane said, the last prime minister of Lesotho. And he was right. Ever since our country found out about the murder scandal involving him and his current wife, everyone wanted him out, and now he's finally stepping down. His current wife was accused of organizing an assassination of the Bane's last wife. Early in the 19th century, there were many wars happening, so many of the Sotho ethnic groups retreated to the mountains. One of the chiefs, Moshweshwe, became a very developed leader during that time and was able to keep his country safe from the invaders. In 1870, when Moshweshwe died, this independence that Lesotho had had weakened. As of this, the Cape Colony, with English ties, tried to make Lesotho one of their territories. This resulted in a war that the Sotho people won. But then, in 1884, Lesotho became British territory. But in 1966, Lesotho gained freedom and then changed its name from Basutoland to Lesotho immediately. In ethnic groups in Lesotho, 99.7% are Sotho. The Sotho people are an ethnic group that are native to South Africa and Lesotho. There are two major branches, the Southern Sotho and the Northern Sotho. Most Sotho people that practice these traditions daily live in a village ruled by a chief. My grandmother tells me stories about the men who sprinkle the homebrew beer and snuff around a symbolic flower to honor our ancestral spirits. My grandfather used to work in the agricultural business, and he says that over 57% of Lesotho's money per year is from agriculture. Lesotho's GDP is at $980, which is very small. He also works with beans, but some of the alternate primary crops are corn, wheat, sorghum, and peas. Over 200,000 orphan children live in Lesotho, out of 2 million. One of the main reasons for this is the HIV and AIDS crisis. The HIV and AIDS crisis is one of the worst in Lesotho, with an astounding 25% of the population has AIDS or HIV. Unsafe housing is also a large issue, with 70% of people living in substandard housing. The lack of access to clean water is also a large issue, with 18.2% of people not having access to it. Even though Lesotho's poverty rate is smaller than it was 15 years ago, over 51% of the population still live in poverty, and that will not decrease if we do not do something. A way that my country can fix this is by employing more people, because then they can earn more wages and make a living off of them. Poverty is a widespread problem in Lesotho, which causes hunger, unemployment, and orphaning. A way we can fix this problem is by employing more people. Although there are many problems in Lesotho, our country is not alone with this struggle. Many struggle with the same issue, and we need to find solutions.